Hello and welcome to my devlog. My name is Martinez and in this video I'll be taking you behind the scenes of my action co-op game where the players have to assemble the conveyor lines and ship goods out of the factory. If you are new to my channel, you may want to check out my previous devlogs to get a better understanding of the game. And if you are interested in the visuals, this video will be a different as I'll be sharing some tips and techniques on how I create my game characters. And as a reminder, if you'd like to support the game, you can find a link to its Steam page in the description below. And if you like this game, don't forget to add it to your wishlist. Thank you for watching and I hope you'll join this video. Well, what I'm up to. I thought since you like how I create features for my game, I will make a video of how I make the characters. As I'm planning to add this character to my game, I need it to be similar to the ones that are already in the game. Yep, that's me drawing with the pencil on the paper. It's easier for me to make a quick sketch and only then bring it to 3D. I will ask you not to be very harsh on my drawing skills since I'm a programmer and not an artist. So I copied the same proportions from my previous characters. I need to make sure that the height of the character, head and gloves are the same size as others. This time I wanted to make a nerdier character who looks like he's already been working here for some time. I wanted his outfit to be more formal, so he wears a long sleeve shirt. Also, since he's a bit of a nerd, I added the straps, and the last detail, the glasses. So this is the final sketch. It's very rough, however, I spent around 20 minutes on it. Oh yeah, I tried to draw him from side view. It didn't go as well. It's still tough for me to figure out the 3D shapes on a 2D plane. Okay, we have the sketch, what now? It's time for modeling. So I uploaded my sketch to the Blender as a guide image. It's easier to stay with the proportion this way. Of course, I'm using the mirror tool to make the model symmetrical and it's very efficient because I can see the changes instantly on the both sides while I'm only modeling the right side. And yeah, I'm struggling there a lot. I was almost sweating while making the body. I believe you noticed that the leggings, the head, and the gloves appeared out of nowhere. I figured there was no use to remodel them again, so I copied them from my other characters. I also wanted him to have a bit of rolled up sleeves as I made in the sketch. It looks a bit weird for now, but I believe it will look much better when I'll add the texture. Okay, so it took me about an hour to make the base body mesh, and I believe it's way too long for this low level character. But you know, it's not a competition, I take my time. Let's move on to the details. I'm making the straps. It's a very basic shape, however, I added a bit more polygons for the final model, since it had trouble when I added the animations. I believe you have a lot to do, so let's skip a bit forward. I made buckles for the straps and the belt. I also modeled the glasses. Oh, and I had a lot of trouble modeling the neck. And there it is. It came out a bit chubby, and I like that. And here comes the part that was very hard to understand for me while I was learning 3D, the unwrapping. I won't go into too much detail here. First, I unwrapped the leggings only. Then, I unwrapped the shirt as a separate island. I also separated the sleeve from the vest. And if you have a question why, I don't have an answer. It just felt right for me this way. And lastly, I unwrapped everything that was left as separate parts. Here you can see the final UV. Oh, and I remember it was very hard for me to understand how to make it symmetrical. I hope this will help someone. You need to unwrap only half of the model and then make it symmetrical. It works because you make the exact copy of the model, meaning that it will also copy the UV coordinates. And here we are. The final model ready for texturing. I use Substance Painter for the texture. I'm doing everything with the mouse, so I didn't paint anything. The other reason I didn't paint much detail is because the other characters are also very basic. So I'll just make a quick time lapse of how I texture everything. Okay, this is the final model with the texture. And I believe you noticed that it doesn't have a face. Yep, it's a horror game, what do you expect? No, I will add the eyes and the mouth on Unity. I do this part separately because I have eyes already animated as sprites, so I just drag them on the face and it works. Now, let's move to the animation. There is not much in this aspect either, since all my characters are using Mixamo rig. If you haven't heard of Mixamo, it's a great tool to rig and animate your models. It does everything by itself. You just upload the model and that's it. It also has a lot of animations, and it's completely free. You may think it's an ad. What a joke. No, I use it very often, and I recommend it if you don't have good skills with animation. Of course, there are animations in my game that were animated by hand. Mixamo also has its limits. However, I uploaded the model to Mixamo and it made me a rig that I uploaded to Unity. I added the texture and the animator controller, the same that other player models already use. Since the rig is the same, it should work. Okay, that was unexpected. Actually, I had trouble there. The scaling and the rotation were wrong, but somehow I managed to upload it right. However, one more thing. Once you download the rig from the Mixamo, it may be not always correct, as you can see in my case. There was something wrong with the armpits, so I had manually repaint some of the bone weights. And there we have it. The brand new factory worker awaits your command. It's not perfect, but... you know what, I don't even have an excuse. I'm planning to add more characters to the game, so you can suggest your ideas in the comments. I'm uploading this video on the last day of 2022. So, have a great new year. I hope to see you again. Bye.